So of course, next video is diving right into the outsourcing. So you don't want to leave you hanging with the options where I said in the previous video, well, I can get a website for $400 to $600. That sounds a little bit better than $4,000 to $6,000 or $10,000 plus. These are some options. You know, feel free to use Upwork as your go-to for not just web development, for copy, for graphic design, and then even your internal operations. People use VAs or virtual assistants for you know, the receptionist or calls or call follow-ups, or maybe building out a CRM, or maybe doing some of your legal research. I mean, really the possibilities are endless. Upwork and I have a little bit of a love-hate relationship. Been using them forever. I've found some people I've been working with for 6-7 years, thanks to Upwork. You know, they've really come through for a lot of great things. My piece of advice is whoever you hire, if you do use Upwork, definitely take advantage of their time tracking. You do not want people to take advantage of the hours that you give them. I don't want to make this daunting. That's only the only bad experience that I had, but otherwise it's been overwhelmingly positive. So pretty much, you know, how do you go about finding a web developer on here? So basically, you know, the first people I just typed in web development and all of a sudden I see $100 an hour. It's like, Ryan, that's not going to be $400 or $600. Yeah, I agree. You know, these people, they, you know, $100 an hour, they've done quite well, of course. It's probably, you know, what you pay for is what you're going to get, but it doesn't always have to be this way, because you might work with this person and say, hey, you look great, 100% job success. You do all these great things. You know, how many hours is this website going to take? They'll say 40. And before you know it, that's, you know, $4,000. And that's not maybe exactly what you had in mind. So how we kind of work with that is that sometimes you can just post specifically what you're looking for. So you'll create an account, go to jobs, you know, post a job post and say, you know, I'm a lawyer with status, I'm looking for X, Y, and Z. Maybe you reference some other websites, maybe you give them an idea of what you're looking for. And then from there, you can start inviting people. But another way we can do it, and you can do this just to see if it works for you, you can do freelancers and agencies, both can represent themselves here, and then immediately, you know, your hourly rate. So how do you get it cheaper? That's pretty cheap. Let's stick around here first. Okay. So then we're going to start getting, you know, different things here. So this person still knows how to do WordPress. They still have a good success rate. You know, we want to make sure that they have a really good success rate. So 90% up. We want to make sure that they've, you know, maybe they've worked with people for a bit. They've been doing this for a while. Maybe we want to make sure that they've at least earned $1,000. We want to make sure that they've at least worked, you know, 100 hours. So we know that they're kind of swinging things. They know what it's like working on here. We want to make sure for, the, you know, frankly, for just like the correspondence going the way that you want it to, especially when you have specific requirements, you want them to be a native or bilingual. And then from here, you're going to start narrowing it down. So also, you know, you see here US only is on. That's when you can also say, you know, I don't really mind if we go overseas if there's other options. So from here, you'll probably be able to really start narrowing it down. Typically, there's additional filters that happens when you do a job posting. But from here, you can go through and you'll start to see people that might be able to do your project for as little as, you know, $10 an hour. You know, there's going to be a correlation between what their ability is and how much they cost and gain, you know, what you want done correctly the first time. So you're really just going to have to, you know, weigh your options. But as far as outsourcing goes, this is a go-to. And yeah, give it a shot.